morning. So today I'm going to talk to you about how to do a 10-minute workout by yourself in your office, at home, in your kitchen, in your living room. It doesn't matter where. I'm going to give you two different things you can give a try. One, you'll use some weights if you have some. If not, it's not a bad idea to invest in some. These are some 8-pound weights that I keep and I use. I actually bring these with me when I travel. But we'll start with just some ways to get some cardio going. So you can do high knees, marching in place. I would do these, count to 30 with both knees, and then get your heart rate up. That's what the whole idea is. You can try body weight squats. So with body weight squats, you're going to want to make sure that you're almost sitting. And when you stand up, you don't want to have too much thrust of your movement. You're just going to stand up, then squat back down. So you don't want too much movement of your knees. You don't want to hyperextend your knees. If your knees are a problem, be really careful with this. So you go down and up, down and up, down and up, down and up. Do that, count to 10, 15, even 20, depending on how your mobility is. You can also do jumping jacks. So this is another way to keep your body moving, get some good exercise in, get your heart rate up. And then the last thing that I throw into my little routine here is side squats. So side squats are, you're gonna stand center, you're gonna go to the right, and then to the left. To the right, and then to the left. Again, count 10, 15, or 20 repetitions with this. It's a great way to get in some exercise. 10 minutes, set your timer 10 minutes. What I usually do is I'll do 10 minutes, but I'll break it down into 2-minute intervals, give myself 30 seconds to recover in between each interval. Next thing you can give a try is if you have a couple of weights at home, I just have 8-pound weights that I use. You can do bicep curls. So with bicep curls, you want to keep your arms steady. Bring the weight up, bring the weight down. Do it slow. If you're not looking for a high level of momentum, this is not meant to get your heart rate up. This is meant to build strength in your arm. Do that for 10 repetitions. If you can, bring it up to 12 or even 15. Bent over row. So with a bent over row, you're gonna lean on your counter or my messy desk in this case. You're gonna put 1 foot forward, 1 foot back. You're gonna bring your arm down straight, and then you're gonna pull up. And you wanna feel the squeeze in your back. Bring it down and up, down and up. That's a bent over row. Do that for, again, 10 repetitions on each arm, maybe 15 repetitions or even up to 20, but you don't want to overtire yourself because you're looking to do this for sets. You can give a shoulder press. So shoulder press, you want to keep your arm nice and even. You're going to push the weight up and bring it down. Up and bring it down. Do these each arm for 10 repetitions. Okay? And then the last thing that I do to get some triceps in is you're going to bend over. This is called a tricep kickback. Bend over so your back is nice and flat. You're going to keep your arm down. You want to keep this nice and even with your back. Bring it back so you can feel the tricep. Bring it down and back and down. This is to work your triceps. You don't need a lot of weight for this. Do this for 10 repetitions on each arm. So set your timer for 10 minutes, go through them until you can, as many reps as possible. Recycle that routine, give it a try, let me know how it works for you.